Hello everyone, and welcome to Lake Superior Quality Innovation Network Learning Session 2. This is the third webinar of the series, which will guide your quality improvement team on how to test changes using a methodology called Plan, Do, Study, Act, or PDSA. I'm Christy Wergeen, and I'm a Program Manager for Lake Superior Quality Innovation Network. And I'm very pleased to introduce Kim Knott, the Director of Nursing Services at Golden Living Center, Wabasso, who will share an example of how their team completed PDSA cycles as they worked on improving their systems and processes related to preventing unintended weight loss. As you can see on this slide, the objectives for this webinar and activity are to describe how PDSA fits into the model for improvement, identify key concepts for testing changes on a small scale using PDSA cycles, and finally to execute a small test of change within your nursing home. In Learning Session 1, we talked about the importance of developing the culture in your nursing home to better support quality improvement. This is really important, and you're going to hear about that a lot in the National Nursing Home Quality Care Collaborative. The National Nursing Home Quality Care Collaborative Change Package offers strategies that your team can implement to develop and enhance your quality culture. By doing this, you'll be able to sustain the changes that you make during this collaborative. One of the strategies of high-performing nursing homes found in the change package is to be a continuous learning organization. And you all listening to this are learning, so you're doing well on this particular strategy. A culture that supports quality plans and implements tests of change using the methodology of Plan, Do, Study, Act. Please refer to the link on this slide to find other proven strategies to improve the quality culture within your nursing home. In the first webinar of this series, Liz spent some time reviewing the model for improvement from the Institute for Healthcare Improvement. This model consists of three questions, and these should be your guide as you work on performance improvement projects. PDSA is initiated when your team is asking the third question on this slide, which is, what changes can we make that will result in an improvement? Hopefully, you've already worked together as a team to set a goal, which does well with that first question, what are we trying to accomplish, and to develop measures, or how will we know that change is an improvement. Now is the time to figure out what to do to make the improvements. Perhaps you've used brainstorming, flowcharting, process mapping, or review of evidence-based practice to come up with ideas for improvement. Or perhaps your team has done root cause analysis to define what the real problem is. Hopefully, one or more of these quality improvement techniques have helped you recognize what system changes have to happen and will result in improvement. Your next step is to use PDSA to test the change and figure out if your hunch or your theory that you came up with will indeed result in an improvement. When doing a PDSA cycle, your team is testing the hunches, the theories, the ideas identified during brainstorming, whatever technique you used. This image on this slide represents how, after testing a change and learning from each test, you may need to refine your changes through several cycles to get the improvement results that your team is looking for. If your teams have completed the webinars and activities in learning session number one, as well as the first two webinars and activities in this learning session, you've already done a lot of thinking. You've hopefully identified at least one area in your nursing home that needs improvement. You've set a goal, you've developed measures, and you've also worked together as a team to determine what changes need to be made in your processes and systems that may result in improvement. And now is the time for the fun part. This is the doing part. Now you get to try out your hunches, what your team has brainstormed together to think will make a difference. And you may want to do this on a small scale. For example, maybe just in one neighborhood, or maybe even with just one resident, to determine if the change in your system is feasible and if it results in improvement before you try it out facility-wide. PDSA does not have to be a complicated process. Let's look at a few examples of PDSA cycles. We will start with an example from Golden Living Center, Wabasso, that Kim Knott will share with us. Kim?
Christy, thank you for inviting me. I'm from Golden Living Center, Wabasso, and we are a 44-bed nursing facility located in Wabasso, Minnesota, in the heart of Redwood County. Golden Living Center's main health care service offerings consist of skilled long-term geriatric care and post-acute rehab care. In addition, we have a unique niche and are licensed by the state of Minnesota to provide outpatient chemical dependency counseling. GLC Wabasso keeps abreast of our areas of concern by reviewing our many areas of data. For this PIP, we review data from Point Right and Minnesota Quality Indicators. During this review, we noted that we had a high number of residents with significant weight loss. Some were losing 5 to 15 pounds per month. Our QAPI team decided we'd try to reduce the number of residents with unintended weight loss by 5.77% in 1 year time. Our actual goal was to reduce our weight loss from 8.77 to 5.77%. The initial changes we made would be to monitor our meal intakes and implement weekly weights. To begin with, we educated our staff on monitoring of weights. Thinking we'd be ahead of the game, we then started weekly weights. We educated the staff that our CNAs would do the weekly weights and then give them to the licensed staff. The licensed staff would then enter the weights into our point-click care system. Weekly, our IDT team reviewed the weights with losses and gains. We're reviewing meal intakes, any eating concerns, meal attendance, weight loss, and even included resident behaviors. For weights that were not stable, the licensed staff were directed to ask for reweighs. The IDT team would ask for therapy referrals as needed and review meds and any changes in conditions. This next slide shows the steps to that process. We really thought our efforts would be successful. However, during our QAPI analyzation, we found that we had only minimal improvements. Our QAPI team then went a little further and analyzed our maintenance checks, our scale calibrations, things like that, etc., and found that that just wasn't it. That wasn't what the problem was. After further brainstorming and monitoring the staff, we found it was a scale issue related to a battery pack on the scale. When there was movement, it would change the weight recorded. QAPI then decided we would purchase a new scale. We then started to process again, thinking this would solve our issue. We educated our staff on the new scale and continued other processes we had already put in place. Our dietary manager considered her process, and we still had weight losses. We again analyzed our data and still found only minimal improvements. We then began audits on our process and competencies of our staff, found that since we had switched from the digital scale to the manual scale, that not all of our staff knew how to operate our new scale. Education was provided through small huddles and all staffing services. We developed an auditing process and have begun the PDSA cycle again.
Thank you, Kim. Your home's experience illustrates very well how it's often necessary to make tweaks to the plan and complete several PDSA cycles, it sounds like you're still doing that, before you've developed a system that will result in the improvement that you're looking for. So we appreciate you sharing that. I want to share another example of how to use PDSA to test change. Magnolia Care Center just completed an employee satisfaction survey, and after reviewing their data, they noted that only 40% of the nursing assistants hired in the last year rated their orientation as positive, and they also found that only 50% of newly hired nursing assistants within the last year were still employed, which was really disturbing to them because they'd been spending a lot of money orienting new staff, and then they ended up leaving. So together, using the IHI model for improvement as a guide, they determined they would like to make the orientation process a positive experience, and they'd also would hope that would decrease the turnover of newly employed nursing assistants. Their hunch was that if they developed a mentorship program and assigned a mentor for all new nursing assistants, they would have a more positive orientation program, better onboarding, and the nursing assistants would be more likely to stay. And they would know if it worked, and if it resulted in improvement, if the percentage of newly hired nursing assistants who rated their orientation as positive increased and the turnover of new nursing assistants decreased. So they had some very specific and easy measures to determine if they made an improvement. So they're now ready to test the change by completing their PDSA, and they start by planning. So they decided that there were three major steps that had to be in place for the program to be started. First, they had to develop the program. Then they had to identify and recruit nursing assistants to serve as the mentors, and they had to train the mentors. They also identified who's responsible for each of these tasks, as well as developed a timeline. So those are two really important things whenever you're putting together a plan. You make sure you know who's responsible and by what dates the work needs to be done, just to keep you on track. Planning continued once the mentors were trained. They chose a date to start pairing mentors to newly hired nursing assistants, and they also created a schedule for monthly mentor meetings. While this was going on, human resources were collecting baseline nursing assistant satisfaction survey data to help them determine if their intervention would result in an improvement. Next comes the do stage. They decided to implement the program throughout the home since they only averaged a couple nursing assistant hires each month, so it didn't really make sense to do it facility-wide. They started to collect data, and the mentors started meeting monthly to discuss how things are going. Those mentor meetings, by the way, turned out to be really positive as they resulted in some great suggestions for improvement. Then the next step was studying the results of the test. So the data that they've collected turned out to be very positive, but it took a while. So it took like 6 months. So this doesn't have to be like a quick thing all the time. They did do a satisfaction survey 6 months after they started their mentor program, and it showed that the number of nursing assistants that rated the orientation as positive increased from 40% to 80%, which was huge, and they were very pleased. In addition, the monthly mentor meetings were quite a success, and the meetings gave the mentors an opportunity to share not only ideas about the mentorship program, but also other ideas to improve the quality of the home. They also found out in these mentor meetings that they didn't have enough trained mentors, because the mentors expressed that it was really difficult to be a mentor to more than one nursing assistant at a time. Finally, the team acted on their findings of this test of change, and they decided to adapt the mentorship program to include annual and, as needed, mentorship training so that each neighborhood had three trained mentors. In addition, they adopted monthly meetings for all the nursing assistants, not just the mentors, since this seemed to be a really positive thing and very valuable to their quality improvement efforts. They also decided to expand the mentorship program to include nurses. And due to the great success that they had, they decided they really didn't need to abandon anything. These two examples demonstrate that PDSA is not a complicated process. Completing PDSA cycles is the backbone of the quality improvement process, and as a matter of fact, your teams are probably completing these cycles regularly, just without putting that label on it. As you work to make improvements, you should be continually trying new things and making changes until you reach the improvement that you're looking for. We want to make sure that your team is comfortable with completing PDSA cycles, so we've included a PDSA cycle worksheet as part of the activity for this webinar, and please review that with your team. On the worksheet, you will find two resources to review with your team. One is a 6-minute video, and it's very entertaining. I think you'll enjoy watching it. And the other is an example of a completed PDSA worksheet that is taken from the RCA Toolkit for Long-Term Care. To help you think about PDSA and how it relates to the performance improvement project that you're currently working on, please review the entries and comments in Donna's diary, which I'll talk about in a minute, for the category most similar to your performance improvement project. A link to Donna's diary is located on your activity sheet. Reviewing these entries, as well as the comments that are after the entries, should help your team brainstorm ideas that may result in a PDSA cycle. The National Nursing Home Quality Care Collaborative is indeed a national collaborative effort. As part of this collaborative, Lake Superior Quality Innovation Network includes over 600 nursing homes in 3 states that are trying all kinds of innovative things to improve the quality of care and the quality of life for residents and for staff. One way to collaborate with each other is by sharing your stories on Donna's Diary. Donna is a fictional DON, and she shares her experience on this diary as she works to implement quality assurance performance improvement practices with her team to enhance the quality culture within her nursing home. We would ask that you would please create an entry on Donna's diary and share what your team has done or are doing or are even thinking about doing so we can learn from each other. To comment on Donna's diary, go to www.donnasnhdiary.org and click on the category, which is found on the right side of the page, that is most similar to what you're working on for your performance improvement project. When you click on the category, you're going to find the diary entry, and then after that will be some comments that are already there. And at the bottom, you're going to find a place to comment on the bottom of the page. So just please comment about a PDSA that you have done, are planning or doing, or just that you're done, that you're working on right now, or thinking about doing in that comment section. And don't forget to come back and read what others have shared, because it just might give your team some really great ideas. Included with this webinar is also a PDSA worksheet for your team to use the next time you're planning a test of change. Thank you for participating in this webinar, and thank you very much, Kim, for joining me. In the next and final webinar for Learning Session 2, you will hear more detailed information that will help your team create an action plan. For further information about PDSA or about the National Nursing Home Quality Care Collaborative, please contact your state Lake Superior Quality Innovation Network lead that's listed on this slide. Thank you very much.